Hey beautiful people, welcome back to my channel Girl Without Dimple. I am Sunheri and I am back with the entire review of the Byju's IAS course. I have done really hard work trying to include every aspect of the course, but if I miss anything you can always ask me, and I would ask you to please watch this video till the very end, because I have tried to cover every minor details in this entire video. So this can be a little long video, please bear with me and let's start the video. Talking about the entire Byju's course, we can divide the Byju's course into two different sections. The first section is the static portion, and the second section is the dynamic section. Under the static portion, we have the books that are provided by the Byju's and the tablet. So we have 18 books altogether and one tablet. So friends, this is my tablet Lenovo M10. On the home screen you can see the Byju's premium app. So without wasting any time, let's quickly open this app. When you open the app, all the subjects are shown here on the first screen. You can see the name of the subjects. Let me read it out for you. Polity, Geography, Economy, History, Environment and Ecology, Disaster Management, Science and Technology, Social Issues, Internal Security, Ethics, Integrity and Aptitude, International Relations, Essay and CSAT. So all the subjects are covered here in the tablet. There are 500 plus hours of video lectures in this tablet. Let's watch a video in Polity. So when you open the subject, here on the top of the screen you can see the number of videos and the number of chapters are reflected. As in the case of Polity, we have 34 chapters and 115 videos. In Polity, the chapters are divided. Like in Introduction to Indian Polity, we have 4 videos. Then we have Union and its Territory, we have 3 videos in that. So after a certain number of chapters, we have practice sets. Here we have the practice set 1. Again, after some chapters are covered, we again have practice set 2. So in Polity, we have a timely revision after some chapters are completed. Let's play a video. Suppose we play Article 14 and 15. So this is how.
In this lecture, we shall discuss part 3 of the Indian Constitution that deals with fundamental rights. So we will be...
As you can see in the video, in all the videos, the mentor or the subject expert will be shown here in the corner of the screen, while the slideshow will play in the background. In the video, you can bookmark a video here, or you can also change the pace of the video as per your requirement. Now all these videos are in compliance with the NCERTs and the standard books. We do not have to read the NCERTs separately. Subjects where NCERT or some of their chapters are important are taught separately. Suppose we open Geography. Here you'll see after the teacher teaches us all the important topics, as we scroll down, you will find some chapters of the NCERT mentioned here. See, class 6, class 7, class 8. Here also not the entire NCERTs are covered, but only those topics from the NCERT are taken up that is important from the UPSC perspective. Now, there are some subjects or topics where we have to go through a thorough reading of NCERTs, like suppose we take economy. So in the economy part, the teacher has already told us to go through some NCERTs. Let me show you. Here. You can see the tutor has given us some references for the books which we have to follow. Here they have also mentioned the NCERT books from class 9 to 12, the macroeconomics or the Indian economic development. So we do not have to struggle between NCERTs, or we do not have to read the entire NCERTs from class 6 to class 12. Only the NCERTs which are must are taught here or are referred here. One good point of BYJU'S is that they are covering SA and the CSAT also here in this tablet, which many of the institutions don't follow. So if we open the SA tab, you can see the chapters such as Introduction to Essay Writing, Basics of Essay Writing, How to Construct an Essay, How to Enrich an Essay. So these are very important to frame a perfect answer for our mains. So we are taught that also. When we come to CSAT, chapters like Quantitative Aptitude, Logical Reasoning, Verbal Ability are also taught in the tablet. So this was the entire look of the tablet. All the other videos here you can see, this is environment and ecology. The video, the interface is very nice, very very beautiful, and you'll feel interested while you access the tablet. We do not require any internet to access the videos. You can access them anywhere, anytime. These are some video recommendations, and there is an option to resume the video. So this was the look of the tab. Is very lightweight, easy to carry. So this was my tablet. So under the dynamic part or the current affairs part, the news part, the first and the foremost important thing for UPSC is the current affairs, the news part. So for that, they have a separate channel on YouTube for where they upload daily the CNA and the DNA. CNA is the comprehensive news analysis, and DNA is the daily news analysis. In these two parts, they cover the Hindu newspaper. So we all UPSC aspirants know the importance of the Hindu. So DNA comprises of the video part, CNA comprises of the written part. So this is the news analysis of the Hindu newspaper, the CNA and the DNA. This is the DNA, the daily news analysis. Let's move ahead towards the end of the video. You will see we are provided with some previous year questions and some prelims questions for practice, which is done in the video itself, and then we are given some mains practice questions. Now if we check the description of the news analysis, you will find some practice questions about of the topics which were discussed in the DNA, then the CNA and its PDF is provided, and then the gist of PIB is provided. You can open from these links. Let's open the CNA. So what we saw was the DNA, daily news analysis in video format, and now this is the CNA, comprehensive news analysis in written format. Different sections are given here. You can see GS1 related, GS2 related. So all the topics of that day's newspaper analysis is given here from the Hindu newspaper, GS4. Now this is the editorial section. So most important editorials from that day's newspaper is covered here, all from mains perspective. They are given, like even the conclusion to these topics are given. Now if we scroll down further, some prelims facts are given, and the tidbits are some less important but still very important topics from that paper. Then UPSC prelims practice questions are given. The answers, you can check the answers right then. Then also UPSC mains practice questions are given here. This is different from what was provided in the DNA. Now you can hear, you can see a list of options like this day in history, topic of the day, some previous year questions, then the weekly updates are given here. The monthly magazine is also provided here. Now we have the webinars.
or as you may say live classes. So we have 3 live classes weekly. Right now, after the prelims is over, we have mains live classes as well. So we have live classes on Mondays, Tuesdays and Thursdays. So you can change the slot of the days as per your choice. So on Mondays, they cover the mains based questions, mains based answer writing practices after the prelims, of course. And on Tuesdays, they cover the important topics from the most important magazines that are required for UPSC, like Yojana, RSTV, Kurukshetra. So all this are covered under in Tuesdays. And on Thursdays, again we discuss the current affairs of the entire month or the week.
So this is the live webinar session going on. We are taught on Zoom platform. The teachers keep on changing from time to time. These are the questions posted by students during the webinar. You can check the answer to your question in the My Questions tab. There are around 4 subject experts to answer your questions during the live webinar.
I can show you the PDF that we've got. So this is the, as you can see, November 2021st week. So this is the handout of the first week, 1 week webinar, and this is the handout of the entire month of September. I have taken this printout of September. So I'll show you that in this monthly or in the weekly part, they cover every different subject. Under polity, we have a number of topics. Under economy, a number of topics are there. So you can see that for every small news, big news, or whatever news that is corresponding to UPSC is covered there. First thing, they cover it on a daily basis, then we have weekly webinars, and then they have monthly webinars. So in that way, we are covering it more than 3 times. So this in a way helps you to revise also and gets you prepared for the mains type of answers also.
So under the dynamic part, we have CNA, DNA, the webinars, the live classes, the weekly magazine, the monthly magazine. So all of these are provided in the dynamic section, which are updated from time to time. Then now let's talk about the tests.
When we talk of tests, we have tests or unit tests actually after every 15 days. So at an interval of 15 days, you will be given on your email ID, the subjective questions will be mailed to you, and the objective ones will be uploaded on your portal. So after the tests, the questions are provided, what you have to do is take a white sheet of paper, write your name, batch number, etc. And then after you write the answers, you have to send a photograph of this answer and mail it to Byju's. So now you can see each of your answer is being checked individually. So you have one-on-one personal attention here, which is the most important part of Byju's. Because I have like if you take an example of any classroom programs, there are a number of students and it is very difficult for a teacher to focus on each and every individual there. But here, like for the answers especially, when you mail it to them, they will check it, they will correct whatever the necessary changes are required, are sent back by them. If you join from 1st March 2020, so 1st March 2020 to 1st March 2021, you will have the entire unit test syllabus with you. So you can plan accordingly how to study, what to study. I would suggest go by the routine that they have provided. So when you get the entire syllabus, you know how to plan your routine. Now, talking next of syllabus. The syllabus provided in the unit test, you can see it over here. I have provided a picture. So the in the syllabus, they have tried to cover the unit test in such a way that you do not have to study one subject all the time or the entire month. They, like in the first time we had polity. In the first test we had polity plus geography. So in the second test it will be maybe history plus science and technology, something like that, so that you will always have variation in your study and you will not feel monotonous. So this again goes for a plus point of Byju's. You have a structured plan, you have proper tests, your answers are reviewed from time to time, the mentor service is there. So all in all, I would say that you have the books, you have the tablet, you have the service. So all you have to do is just study and do nothing else. You do not have to plan, you do not have to think of NCERTs, what to study, what not to study. Everything is just served in your plate. All you have to do is to eat. Let's talk about the mentorship. Please ignore me for my bad handwriting. In the mentorship, as we have seen, like in the live classes, we have one subject expert plus around three or four mentors who are there to answer your queries on chat box. So apart from this, suppose you have a doubt late at night or some other time of the day when you don't have any classes, at that time you can call the number given to you in the mentorship number. Now suppose you have a doubt late at night when the mentorship service is not available, that time you can email them. You can email your queries, your doubts there, and as soon as they receive it, they'll try to solve your doubt at the earliest. This again goes for a plus point of Byju's.
So this is our student portal. All the resources, the subjects are covered here. Topics which are already covered in the tablet and are of more importance are again covered here. Like this is polity, we have current affairs of polity and engineering constitution, which is of utmost importance. Then some important parts of geography again covered here. Then coming down, we have the current affairs monthly magazines available for download over here. You can see the list of options to download them. This is where I download the monthly magazines. Then coming down, we have the NCERT tests of different subjects. You can attempt the tests over here. Then this is where the prelims test series of the previous years are provided. The resources include the hybrid explainers, mains, value addition series. These are again, you can say, ornaments to make your study more interesting. Then in the corrigendum section, if there were any mistakes in the tablet or in the live webinars, they are corrected here in the corrigendum part. Make sure you keep checking them. Then if we see, we have some unit tests. This is in the homework section. The tablet is available in Hindi and English version, so the tests are also given here in English and Hindi. This is the mains tests and this is the prelims tests. You can attempt them anywhere and anytime you wish.
One of the best things that I find in Byju's is, which I think no other institution is providing right now, is after you clear your prelims, you go for your mains. After prelims, they have mains based test series on a regular basis. All India test series are conducted. Mains based answer writing practice is done almost every other day. Then after, when you clear your mains and you have your interview round. So for the preparation of interview, Byju's does not leave you alone here. They assist you for the preparation of interview as well. So you will be sent to Delhi or any of the headquarters of Baidu's, where you will be trained for your UPSC interview, the final interview that is going to happen. And from the interval, from mains to interview, your entire fooding and lodging in Delhi or wherever place you stay is covered by Baidu's. So this is one of a gold opportunity for Baidu's students. I don't think this is provided by any other institution as for now. Apart from all this that we have joined, apart from the 500 plus hours of the video and the books and the course, we also have the Baidu's BHLP program. That is Baidu's home learning program. So in this, that is usually of lesser price. So in this, it is more like a crash course program in which all the subjects are covered for a month, and they are taught in live classes. You can interact with the teachers, and under this they cover all the current. They teach correlating with the current affairs of that time. So this is a crash course, and this is very beneficial. I have not joined it yet because I have planned to first complete the basics, to complete the 500 hours first, and then I'll join this. Now talking of the optional subject, this is a very important aspect if seen from for UPSC. As for now, Baidu's only covers sociology for the optional program. We hope to see some other subjects added to it as well. So this was the entire coverage of the Baidu's course. If you ask me about, many people ask me about the price of the course. So I have attached the link of the course where you can see the price and all, because it varies from student to student, and many a times there are scholarship tests as well. So I would tell you to check for prices on the sites which I'll be providing. I've also provided the number through which you can contact Baidu's. Please do not trust any other external sources, as they can be fraud or spam. So with this, we come to the end of our video. I would suggest you go through the Baidu's app once before joining the program, see some videos, and then decide for yourself whether you should go for this or not. And if you have any doubts, as I said, you can always ask me in the comments box. I am more than happy to help you out. So that's all for today. Meet you until next video. It's a goodbye from Sunheri. Hasta la vista.